everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. In today's matchup, we've got a pair of running backs who are hoping for plenty of touches come their way. It's Miller's Texans going up against Blunt's Patriots. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. While the skies may be ominous, there's never a bad day for football. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Houston Texans and the New England Patriots. Hi again, everybody. I'm Brandon Godden. To my left, as always, he's Charles Davis. And Charles, we saw in the open, we've got a couple of great running backs in this game tonight, each capable of putting a team on his back.
And I'm excited to talk about the runners, not just the passers, who have a big hand in who's going to win this game. Both of these guys are do-it-all, can run it, can catch it. I can't wait to get this one started.
Here's Steven Goskowski now to kick this one off. And we are underway in Foxborough. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And here comes Brock Osweiler and the Houston Texans. Big win, first round of the playoffs against Oakland. A little bit of a redemption for Osweiler. Numbers weren't the best, 14-25, 168 yards and a touchdown. But just to get a playoff win after so much has gone against him this year in the media, probably a nice thing.
I thought it was a great thing for not just him, but for the Texans as a whole. Because remember, they signed him, the huge offseason signing, the quarterback they needed to get over the hump. And he lost his job before the end of the regular season. Able to get it back for the playoffs and get that win, that's why they signed him. That's what he has to build on.
They go play action here on first down. Trying to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over.
Brandon, when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach and talked about how they wanted to begin this game offensively, they talked about their script, didn't they? 10 to 15 plays, the first 10 to 15 they had on their script. Nowhere on the script was there throwing an interception, I have to believe.
Yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, fifth in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
What they want to do each and every week is make a game plan based on their opponent, not so much their own personnel, and they try to attack that way.
They fake the handoff. Now Brady. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. 23 yards on the play.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
Fresh set of downs here. Brady gives now to Blunt, and he'll get this one down to about the 17. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Again, here's Blunt, looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
There's so many things that go into playing the position of linebacker. Some of them are actually subtle. Doing the drill work that you do all the time in practice and carrying it over to the game, get rid of blockers, and get to the ball carrier, knock him down for a loss.
And the offense needs 7 out of this play on third down. Throwing is Brady on third down. Over the middle, Julian Edelman, it's complete. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Keep it. He's going to try to run for it. They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work.
I know coaches always tell us that they make decisions about these types of plays, this type of a fake, earlier in the week to take the emotion out of the deal. I don't know that that was really true here. This one felt like all of a sudden, hey, I have a feeling about it. Let's go ahead and get it. And it just didn't work.
Yeah, I know one thing. They wish they had it back.
Yeah, they certainly do. But the buck stops with the head coach on that one. He has to green light that attempt.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. This one complete, it's C.J. Fedorowicz. A gain of 6 there on first.
And there's a completion to the tight end, and look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
On second down, Osweiler. Mumphrey with it over the middle. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
Now Osweiler on first down. And this one complete to Will Fuller. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender. And that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
This is Lamar Miller. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
So, Brandon, as we prepare for Houston's game against Oakland in the wild card playoffs, I think we both agreed that running back Lamar Miller for the Texans would naturally be a focal point.
And he was. 31 carries, most of any of the tailbacks this past weekend in the wild card games. 73 yards and a touchdown. They didn't need a whole lot offensively, though, because their defense was so good.
Their defense, number one ranked in the NFL all season long, held up very well against Oakland in the playoffs. That allowed Lamar Miller to control the game by carrying the football 31 times.
And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. They'll run it now out of the gun. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
As a guy carrying the ball, your eyes are going to direct your feet, and you're hoping they carry you to the open spaces. But it's awfully difficult at times because you have so many things you have to look out for. Where's the line blocking? Where's the traffic coming from? Tough to find open spots.
Come on, they'll throw it with Osweiler. Surveying the field. Look at the time. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. From the shotgun, Osweiler finding time. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. On fourth down, here's the veteran Shane Leckler to punt it away. Back deep, Danny Amendola for New England. And this is blocked. The Pats bring heat and they get home. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. And he will score. Touchdown, Patriots.
Partners, you well know every block punt wasn't necessarily a called block. Sometimes the guy just finds his way back there. Doesn't matter. The play happens. And that one turned into 6 points because they handled it so well after the block.
Now Steven Goskowski on for the extra point. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots. So the very rare blocked punt scooped and returned for a touchdown. What an exciting play. So after the punt return touchdown, let's see what their opponents can do with this kickoff. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. As the Houston Texans trot back out, you know, this offense last year in the wild card round put up a goose egg against Kansas City, lost 30-0. So while they had their moments that weren't so great in round one this year, they did get 27 points on the board in a big win.
You just felt like that was such a great learning experience for them, and they really put it to good practice in this year's wild card game. Remember, last season they gave up the opening kickoff for a touchdown. So they were chasing right from the word go. This year's game, they controlled the game, got out in front. I think Bill O'Brien had his guys ready to play.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Lamar Miller. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. A quick look here at the Patriot defense.
It seems like whenever people talk about Chris Long, the number one thing they discuss is his motor and how relentless he is. Let's not forget, he's also a superior athlete.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll run it again with Miller. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt. An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Here's Osweiler. And this is going to be incomplete. He was looking for Keith Mumphrey that time. And now it's fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Here's Shane Leckler now. On for his second punt. And remember, his first one was blocked. That's taken on the 25. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Patriots take over. And now we get a peek at Tom Brady, who has had 2 weeks to prepare for the divisional round game when they will face Houston at home. Of course, Tom, we know what he's done this year. Possible third MVP coming up for number 12.
He's been sensational. Let's just go ahead and put that on the table. And he has that fuel, that desire for another championship. So don't expect anything less than his best as the playoffs go on. Brock Osweiler in Houston coming to town. It's a decided advantage for Tom Brady.
In Brady's 12 starts, 11-1 this year.
We got three.
They'll begin here with Blunt. And some room to roam now. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. It's a gain of 24 that time. And it gives the Pats a first down.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. But they didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, it created a big run. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. On first and 10, here's Brady. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Jadeveon Clowney, able to get in there and take him down for a loss of 3. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback because he had no chance to block him.
They come up in an offset eye. Brady to throw on second down. Over the middle, Julian Edelman, it's complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Brady now on first down. And that's going to be incomplete. LeGarrette Blount was the intended target. And now it's second down. This is the offense we're going to see coming up in this one, and LeGarrette Blount, the featured back.
The big knock on him coming out of college was his lack of speed, but it's definitely not his lack of power. He runs right through opposing tacklers and sets things up big for his offense.
Play action, now it's Brady. And this is caught at the 8. And they do stop him, but he takes it all the way to the 2.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
No, I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Let's go.
They'll go to Blunt, try and pound it in. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
There are so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day, get the blocker away, and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. He lost 4 there, and it's third down.
On goal-to-goal runs, when you create lost yardage plays, the only way that happens is either called pressure or what I like to call straight-ahead pursuit, a great read, and they get to the backfield and make the play.
And that was a big chunk of yardage lost. So they're back at the 7 now for third and goal. Now Brady. And almost intercepted. Would have been a huge pick in the end zone, but as it stands, that brings up 4th. Charles, that's an important third down stop. You don't want to spot him 2 touchdowns here early.
You're trying to slow momentum down. You've already given up the score. They're coming right back at you. You're exactly right. Being able to hold them there and force a decision on 4th down, that's big for the defense.
So now on 4th down, on comes Steven Goskowski to try and get the patch 3. This just a 24-yard attempt. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and the lead moves to 10-0. So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
Goskowski now converted for 3. Now he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the 3 and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. They begin with a run by Miller. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only 1 on that play.
So what will they do? On the ground, through the air? Let's see. 2nd and 9. Throwing, Osweiler. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
Let's go! Green, 39!
Play action. It's Osweiler. And that is incomplete. C.J. Fedorowicz, the intended receiver. And fourth down coming up. Here's Shane Leckler now. Remember, though, he did have one blocked earlier. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. It's taken to the 26. It's a 41-yard punt, but just a net of 31 following the run back. And that will come the offense as they take over. So the Patriots coming out now. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
On first down, Brady. Got a man complete. It's Chris Hogan. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
On play action, now Brady. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Christian Covington coming hard that time. He's able to run him down for a loss of 12. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result?
Sack.
Quarterback gets hit.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've hit the end of quarter one. 10-0 our score, and we'll return to Foxborough after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. And the offense now will try to regroup after the sack on second down. So third and 15 and an extra defensive back in the game now.
Flooding the passing lanes.
Here's Brady, and he'll have his man, that's Edelman. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
On first and 10, here's Brady. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it.
Three down.
By 20.
We're yard. He'll try again on second down. Screen pass to Blunt. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. Now that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
Throwing now is Brady. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. On fourth down, on now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. Back deep for the Texans is Tyler Irvin. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. And now out comes Houston. And last drive, three and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. They isolate Hopkins on the left side. Now Osweiler on first down. Right side caught Fedorowicz. 12 yards on the pickup, and the Texans are going to have a first.
Okay, when the big guy runs a corner route, you're asking a lot no matter who's covering him. Doesn't matter whether it's a linebacker or a defensive back. Yeah. He usually has the advantage because of his body type.
First down carry now for Miller. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 13 on the pickup there. And that'll be good for a Houston first.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
They keep it with Miller on first down. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And the offense still has a couple plays to go to pick up the first on second down and three.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
Play action. It's Osweiler going up top into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively, and you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins, let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively.
By 20!
They start on the ground here with Blunt. And he'll get this one up. to about the 39 here. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back. And now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward, watching it on tape. Maybe they can keep incorporating that type of a run into their offense.
They'll run again with Blunt. And Blunt loses the football. And the Texans scoop it. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Now the Texans offense, they head back out to do battle here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit.
Here we go now. Boom,
following the fumble recovery, it's Osweiler. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Patrick Chung. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. So that is three interceptions now in this first half. And you hate to ask the question, but yeah, let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
Starts with a handoff to Blunt. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think of one. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
He'll get about four here, down to the 43-yard line. Andre Howell, the one to bring him down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down following the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
It's really come into vogue to talk about the different gaps that a defense tries to attack in an offensive line. And most of the time, we're talking about blitzes. How many times have you heard double A-gap blitz? But where is the A-gap? It's the space between the center and the guards, either side. So when you're having a double A-gap blitz, that's two guys coming through that gap. In this situation, though, that A-gap wasn't open for the defense to exploit. The offensive line took care of it, protected it, and moved the defensive guys out of the way to allow for that nice run.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Now he'll throw with Brady. Left side, that's caught by Mitchell. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And a gain there of 11 yards. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Brady now on first down. Incomplete. Malcolm Mitchell out of the University of Georgia was the intended receiver. And that'll bring up 2nd down. Offense still needing 10 yards. 2nd down. They come out here in the eye. Brady going to throw. Deep drop. Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack.
Holding offense.
Ninth play of the drive now on 3rd and a country mile.
Hey, 20. We've got three.
They go play action for White. Now it's Brady. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now 4th down.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field and it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
And Gostkowski's kick is good. And that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
Gostkowski now converted for 3. Now he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And the Texans set to come onto the field. And with 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. And it's the linebacker, Shay McClellan, with a pick. And they have the football that will set up shop at the 33-yard line. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown 4 picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw 4 in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
And a great spot to start this drive from here. Here's Blunt. And not much running room. Down to the 32. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll run it here with Blunt. And he'll get about three as he's brought down to the 28. The big man, Vince Wilfork, able to get him down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and five. Now a play fake, Brady. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Whitney Merciless with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of seven.
Now we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Goskowski now for the Pats field goal try. It'll be spotted on the right hash, a 52-yard attempt. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
The Texans offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. And last time, one play interception, so this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, you get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Counter, it's Miller, and now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. On second down, Osweiler. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Alan Branch able to swap him from that defensive tackle spot for a loss of five.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
The O-line will have to do a better job protecting here on third down after that sack.
Let's go! Green 39! Green 39!
Out of the gun, it's Osweiler. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And this is taken in at the five. A huge play there for Houston. 59 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They'll try and run for it with Miller. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick-hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before that. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They isolate Hopkins on the left side.
Here we go.
Now Osweiler on second down. This will be caught at about the five. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
From the three now, here they come on third and goal.
Green 39! Green 39!
Here's Osweiler. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. C.J. Fedorowicz, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans have cut it to within a score. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
And that'll make it 13-7.
Roughing the kicker. Defense.
Uh-oh, flag comes out here. This is going to be roughing the kicker.
When you're going back there on the kick block, you've got to go to the right point. That didn't happen. Ran into the kicker. The penalty flag had to come out.
Now it's Novak on. He'll send this one away following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Three down. Let's go!
On first down, Brady. He's got time. And this one complete to Martellus Bennett. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line.
coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. Brady now on first down. The throw left side complete to Hogan. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. So the offense looking at a second and eight. To throw on second down, and he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. He's got daylight, and they will score a pick six for the Texans TD. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Novak is on to attempt the extra point. And that one will give them the lead here as we approach halftime. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Danny Amendola on the return. And he'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And he'll be taken down right around the 27. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Blunt, the lone running back. And he'll get it up the middle. And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act of this first half. So we have reached halftime here. It's the visitors, the Texans, out in front. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
All right, let's do it. Here's a look at the first half highlights. Third down from the 37. Osweiler's got his mark near the sideline. He would pick up 2 yards and then duck out of bounds. Later on the drive, here it's C.J. Fedorowicz making the catch in traffic. And this play goes for a score. The gap is closed to 6. Now first and 10, Brady's on target here, and he'll end up at the 40-yard line before being tackled. Continuing on the drive, the pass ends up being picked off. Merciless going to run it all the way back for the score. The Texans go up by 1. We're set up for a great second half, so let's get you out to it. Here's Brandon Guyton.
All right, thank you, Larry. Plenty of intrigue to come. A 1-point game as we get set for half 2. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. They'll run it now out of the gun. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. Now Brady. Screen pass to Blunt. They find some open field here. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
So the offense has it 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
On 2nd down, here's Brady. Left side, that's caught by Mitchell. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down. Third down now following the completed pass. Here's Brady to throw. This is White on the screen. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now a carry for Blunt. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. Able to push forward for about 4 down to the 37. John Simon in on the stop.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. And he'll give it here to his running back. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
No surprise there, Jadeveon Clowney with a tackle for loss. We all know how he became one of the most famous players in football, though, don't we remember?
Oh, that one play.
Yeah, that one big-time play. It was on highlights everywhere. They want to see more of that here in the NFL.
So on 4th down, Brady will yield to Gostkowski for the field goal try. This officially a 55-yard attempt. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this score will stay right where it is. So another long try for 3 and another kick that comes up lacking.
Yeah, this isn't going to do any wonders for his field goal percentage, but you have to figure as a head coach that when you send a guy out there to try and kick from that distance, it's a 50-50 proposition at best.
A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Yeah, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Try and get the run game going. This is Miller. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. The defensive tackle, Alan Branch, is the one to bring him down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Again, it's Miller. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6. From midfield now, here's Osweiler. He's got time in the pocket. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
Here's Shane Leckler now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is. At the 6-yard line. Back out for another drive comes LeGarrette Blount. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on our side of the ball. They went in at halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in how their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They've come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
2nd down following the run. Toss play to Blunt, and they'll hit him for a loss as he's back to his 2-yard line.
One of the toughest things for an offensive lineman to learn is the ability to get in space and hit people who are moving targets. And linebackers are not easy ones to hit because they know how to move, juke, and make you miss. And that's exactly what he did on that play. A nice play for the defense.
Here. This is James White, and he'll get this only up to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a 4th down.
Well, the guys who are paid to make the tackles deserve some kudos there, but I think they deserve even bigger ones because in that situation, they had to be thinking pass. Loosened up defense, going to pass coverage. Instead, maybe they surprised him a little bit running the ball, yet they rallied to it and stopped him well short of a 1st down.
And he's able to get it out of there. Taking a couple yards shy of midfield. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Texans with great field position to start this drive as they take over 1st and 10. And now out comes Houston. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And they'll start this drive with very good field position. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
I'm ready now for 2nd and 9. Now Osweiler. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Chris Long in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively, pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well, and that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
Second down, sacked by the defense. What type of pressure will they bring here on 3rd? We'll see.
All right, here we go.
Out of the gun, it's Osweiler. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20.
And I know you can't really see it, but that play spells frustration. With a capital F for the guys on defense. They covered everyone else, end up going to the running back out of the backfield, and he picks up a back-breaking 1st down.
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. First and 10, it's Osweiler. Looking for someone to throw to. Right side, caught, Fedorowicz. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end, and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Miller, the lone set man. Osweiler. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
It's third down, 6 yards to go for the offense.
Here we go now.
Throwing again, Osweiler. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. Down here in the red zone, you know your tight end's going to be a favorite target. Couldn't hang on.
And sometimes they just have to get out of their own head because they understand how tight windows are there and how many bodies are there. And sometimes they just overthink it and don't catch the ball.
And Novak's kick is good. And that'll move their lead up to 4 now. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
Now it's Nick Novak back out following his field goal to send it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Brady now on first down. Surveying the field. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. Charles, switching gears as we glance at the NFL playoff picture and what's left. You got the Blue Bloods remaining. This decade, New England has been in the divisional round all 7 years. Seattle and Green Bay now 6 of the 7. That's consistency.
That it is, and that means in the divisional round, you have teams like Houston and Atlanta that are really trying to crash the party. Neither one of them has been to a Super Bowl yet.
Yeah, we'll see if they can get that done. Should be an interesting weekend of football. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4.
And looking at this play from the running back's perspective, as it developed, I know he had to think to himself, oh no, here they come.
Here's Ryan Allen now, as he's on to punt for New England. This is fielded at the 27. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the offense will come back onto the field for the 1st and 10. towards the Texans now. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yep. Run what
put
you
your
do
foot
best.
On the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try and increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. From the gun, it's Osweiler. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Partner, before the game, we were discussing Aaron Rodgers having Green Bay in the win column for seven straight games so hot, and I think you have to look at him and Cobb as two of the top performers from Wild Card Weekend.
I would agree totally. I mean, Aaron Rodgers, four touchdown passes, no interceptions, the Hail Mary to Randall Cobb right before the half against the Giants, that really elevated their performance. And Randall Cobb had five catches, 116 yards, and three touchdowns. Excited to be back on the field after a Week 15 injury. But how about Seattle? Bully ball was back in effect. Thomas Rawls, a tailback, over 160 yards on the ground. He more than set a tone for the Seahawks.
Yeah, those guys shined in the NFC. And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. They go play action with Osweiler. Finding time. He's going to air one out. And now here is another interception. Devin McCourty picks it off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so
well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and eight. Brady to throw on second down. And right side caught Hogan. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Offense faces a third and medium with 6 yards left. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now in Foxborough. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. Get up. And ready for third and six. Throwing is Brady on third down. And complete on the right side to Bennett. A gain of eight and a first down.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Throwing on first down is Brady. Sets up the screen to Lewis. And some room to work. He won't go down. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
On first and 10, here's Brady. Going underneath to Blunt. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Give him six on the play, and it'll be a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Again, it's Brady. He's got time. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
And here comes play number six on this drive. Now Brady again. This is White on the screen. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. Only two on the screen pass there, and it'll be fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Here's the battering ram Blunt. Muscles him off. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. It'll be a gain of nine, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down.
Well, you've got a kicker who's missed one earlier. So instead of sending him out there to try a long one, they say, let's just go for it. And they'll wind up picking up the first down.
So it'll be first down here after the run. Shotgun now for Brady. And he dumps it off to Blunt. And down inside the 15 he goes. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Brady gives this one to Lewis. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about three.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved.
False start, offense.
First times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
But that certainly felt like an example of a defense just saying, okay, we've had enough. We've gotten mashed all night long. About time we got a good play in. But flip it over to the offensive side. They've got to be really upset that they allowed a play like that to happen. They were pitching such a great game. They want to keep it going.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And it'll push his way up to about the 14. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And Gostkowski's kick is good. And that'll bring him back within a point. All right, so this one's now back within a field goal. And if anybody tells you they see how this one's going to end, I'd have to say they're probably lying, Charles.
And this game's had more twists and turns than a good mystery novel. And I have a feeling we've got a few more twists and turns in store for us before they shake hands here.
Gostkowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. Oh, look at the juke. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Comes Houston. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Osweiler, he's got time in the pocket. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Chris Long. In there to drop it for his second sack now here tonight.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
Here we go. Boom, landed.
Now Osweiler on second down. Looking sideline, incomplete. The Patriots going with a dime package here. Two extra defensive backs on third. From the gun, it's Osweiler. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. It'll be a gain of eight, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down a distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Here's Shane Leckler now, as he's on to punt for Houston. On his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. This will be fielded at the 17. 12 yards on the return that time, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Texans defense, we watch them get set to go. And last time out, they gave up the chip shot field goal, but obviously could have been worse than that. I think they felt pretty good about only giving up three.
No doubt about it. Anytime an offense gets into the red zone, the thinking naturally for the defense is, okay, 3 points. We're going to give up three here, but let's make it no more than that. They met their goal.
On the other side, though, the offense, they weren't very happy.
No, because there's an opportunity. Once you get to the red zone, you're not thinking about kicking a field goal. You're thinking about how do you get into the end zone, and when you don't, you walk off the field feeling a little bit of failure on that drive.
Yeah, who will have the better feeling at the end of this drive? And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady surveying the field. Left side, that's caught by Mitchell. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. The reception good for seven. It's third down. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
Blunt, the lone running back. And he'll get it up the middle. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Face mask penalty. And Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make a tackle. So you end up flailing away, and your hand gets into the wrong spot.
Throwing on first down is Brady. Wide open, Julian Edelman. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looks pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Now a play fake here on first down. Finding time. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
20! 20!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a good gain of 11. Sets them up first and goal.
Really good, skillful, tough running throughout this contest. Picked up first down after first down. He's got to have a nickname, doesn't he? How about the human first down machine? I think that fits.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. This is Lewis. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. Now flags come in. Looked like one of the Patriots might have moved.
False start, offense.
Losing yardage back at the 12. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
Not only was that a terrific play, but that loss of yardage they created this close to their own goal line, that gives them a little breathing room now as they move them back.
And they're breathing fire a little bit right now, aren't they?
A lot of confidence being shown by them at this point of the game.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. An extra defensive back in the game here on 3rd and goal. Now a carry for White. And here he'll get it down to the 7. A good job there defensively to stop him for a gain of just 4. And that'll bring up 4th and goal.
Another stop on 3rd down. And this defense still hasn't allowed a touchdown to this point.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This for the lead in the final stages. And Gostkowski's kick is good. And with that, they will move ahead by 2 here in the 4th. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know, the field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
Gostkowski now converted for 3. Now he'll kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Heading out is the Texans offense as they get set to take over here. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complimentary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth.
Back it up, Philly. Here we go.
On first down, Osweiler. And to the left side, Fedorowicz has it. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They come up on a 1st and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On first and 10, it's Osweiler. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. He's got time. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, the hit pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
So here we go now. Extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Back to throw. And finding Fedorowicz. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They'll look to throw. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Back to throw. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. Blow and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's second and 12. Now Miller, he's had a big workload here tonight. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. He'll look to throw. And that's incomplete.
Ball is on pass. Offense.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. Miller, the lone setback. He'll get the football here. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Lamar Miller, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Texans have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
And touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Yeah, part one is done, but now on the sideline, you can already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
So that drive goes a full 80 yards and 10 plays. And Lamar Miller caps it off with a touchdown run. Now it's Novak on. He'll send this one away following the touchdown. This will be fielded at the 6. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Brady to throw. And he can't hang on to it. That would have sealed it. Instead, second down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. To throw is Brady. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Whitney Merciless in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Back to throw, Brady. And this is going to be incomplete. Down by 5, they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Now Brady, got to have this one. He's got time in the pocket. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. So they had to take the shot there. Obviously, that was pretty much it, their last chance.
No other play for them, right? I mean, there's no other choice. It's not like you can have some strategy move, right? Punt it away and hope to... No, that's what they had to do. Right now, that offensive unit, they're pretty discouraged on the sidelines. They're going to feel like they let the team down in that situation, but they were in a tough spot to begin with.
And with no timeouts now, they just need a miracle.
Yeah, an absolute miracle. If the team that has the ball, just find a way to run out the clock, take care of the ball, and go home a winner.
The Texans offense now, they get set to head back on the field here. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one possession game. This one not fully over yet. Osweiler to a knee, and that should wrap this one up. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. From Foxborough, good night, everybody.